I was looking for some answers why things are like they are. The world has problem after problem, each day they're more bizarre. I kept hearing all these answers, no one explained my plight. They led me in the wrong direction, I didn't know wrong from right. That's when I picked up God's word to read.
Now I know
the Bible speaks. The Bible speaks. The Bible speaks. The Bible speaks. The Bible speaks.
Hello, I'm Brother Boy from the Israel of God, coming to you teaching the Word of God by title and subject. Today, sisters and brothers, we're going to deal with the title, The Shield of Faith. The shield of faith. You know, a lot of us say we serve God and we want to do what He say, but the whole thing, sisters and brothers, we don't do it. And the only reason that I could come, the only conclusion I can come to is that we don't believe in Him. Because if you believe in something, you will promote it. If you believe like a child believe that in their parent and fear their parent, they would obey Him. If you believe in God, then you should do all that He wants you to do. But sometimes we don't have that belief. We don't have the faith. And when you don't have faith, sisters and brothers, you don't please God. And a lot of things that you try to do don't come to pass or don't come to fruition because you simply don't have faith. But we're going to deal with the shield of faith because your faith is what protects you. Your faith and your God and His word is what sustains you. And if you don't have it, then you cannot serve God, sisters and brothers. Now let's have a look at this. We're going to go into Hebrews, the 11th chapter, and we're going to start at verse 1. Hebrews 11 and 1. Go ahead.
Now, faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen.
Go ahead.
For by it the elders obtained a good report.
Now, if you have faith in God, then you're hoping that He will give you what He promised. And the reason that you have this hope is because you have seen evidence that He is. And by this same faith, it said the elders received a good report. It didn't say they got saved. They received a good report. Go ahead and read.
Through faith, we understand that the worlds were framed by the word of God. So that things which are seen were not made of things which do appear.
Now, we understand that it was there through faith because we believe the Lord. None of us was there when the Lord spoke and formed the world. None of us was there when the world was created. But we read in the Bible that God did it, and it shows us how He did it, and we believe that because we believe in Him. Skip down to verse 5 and go ahead.
By faith, Enoch was translated that he should not see death.
Go ahead.
And was not found.
Go ahead.
Because God had translated him. For before his translation, he had this testimony that he pleased God.
See now, Enoch had finished his course. He walked with God for 300 years, and him and God walked and talked. And God just saw, hey, this man here is complete. I don't have no reason for him to stay around. So He changed him. Didn't take him to heaven. But He did. He put the change in him, sisters and brothers. Enoch is running around on this earth somewhere today. We can't see him because he's under the same condition that the Lord had the angels under, that the third that followed Satan under chains of darkness. Because if we could see Enoch, then we would have a problem with it. But he's here. Go ahead and read.
But without faith, it is impossible to please Him.
Now I said, but without faith, it is impossible to please God, sisters and brothers. Go ahead and read.
For he that cometh to God must believe that He is, and that He is a rewarder of them that diligently seek Him.
Now how can you come to God if you don't believe He exists? And how can you obey a God that you don't even think is here? All we're doing is we're reading a book that somebody wrote, but there ain't no God. So how can you believe in it? So without faith, sisters and brothers, it's impossible to believe God. First thing is you have to believe that he is. Let's go into Galatians, the third chapter. Galatians, the third chapter. And let's start reading at verse 1. Galatians 3 and 1. Okay, go ahead.
O foolish Galatians, who hath bewitched you that ye should not obey the truth, before whose eyes Jesus Christ hath been evidently set forth, crucified among you?
Now look, Paul had taught these Galatians about the Lord. But what they did, these Galatians went back to the law. I'm not talking about the commandment. They started keeping the laws of animal sacrifice. Go ahead and read.
This only would I learn of you. Received ye the Spirit by the works of the law?
Go ahead.
Or by the hearing of faith?
Now, did you receive the Spirit by the works of the law, by killing animals, or by hearing the word of God? Skip down to verse 11 and go ahead.
But that no man is justified by the law in the sight of God. It is evident, for the just shall live by faith.
Look, sisters and brothers, nobody is justified by the law, but this is the law of animal sacrifice. And this is why Paul asked this question, made the observation here. Skip down to verse 19 and go ahead.
Wherefore then serveth the law?
It
was added because of transgressions, till the seed should come to whom the promise was made.
He said, now wherefore then serve the law? It was added because of transgression until Jesus came, sisters and brothers. Why serve it? See, when people read this in Galatians, the third chapter, they think this is talking about God's commandment, but it's not. It's talking about the law of animal sacrifice, because it was added because of transgression. Because you have to ask, what is sin? Sin is a transgression of the law. So if sin is a transgression of the law, how can you add the law because of sin?
That's right.
Because you have one law, the royal law, and you had the animal law of animal sacrifices added because of sin. But skip down to verse 24 and go ahead, because this law was added because of transgression. Go ahead.
Wherefore the law was our schoolmaster to bring us unto Christ, that we might be justified by faith.
Now this law was our schoolmaster to bring us to Jesus. So now when we got to Jesus, then we have to live by our belief.
That's right.
Go ahead and read.
But after that faith is come, we are no longer under a schoolmaster.
Go ahead.
For ye are the children of God by faith in Christ Jesus.
So now after Jesus came, sisters and brothers, you are no longer under the schoolmaster. I know it said, since faith has came, faith is not an entity. It don't walk in, sisters and brothers. Since Jesus came, we are no longer under the law. So now we are under the blood of Jesus, sisters and brothers. It is our belief. Now, but as far as the commandment is concerned, let's see if this faith do any harm to the commandment. Let's go into Romans, the third chapter. Romans chapter 3. Because people need to read some of this stuff so you will stop making foolish statements to me. You don't have to keep the commandment now because we're under the faith. No, you don't have to kill animals no more because you are under faith. Because Jesus came and all you have to do is believe. Verse 28, Romans 3 and 28. Go ahead.
Therefore, we conclude that a man is justified by faith without the deeds of the law.
Now, we come to the conclusion that man is justified through faith without killing animals. Skip down to verse 31. Go ahead and read.
Do we then make void the law through faith?
Do we then make void the law? This law here is the royal law. Do we then make void the law through faith? Go ahead.
God forbid. Yeah, we established the law.
God forbid, we establish the law. If you believe in God and you believe in and you believe that he is a rewarder of those that obey him, then you will not steal, you will not kill, you will not commit adultery, you will not bear false witness, sisters and brothers, and you won't break any of the Lord's commandments. You will honor the Sabbath day and remember to keep it holy. If you believe, if you had faith, because it will establish the law. Let's go on Ephesians, the sixth chapter, and start reading at verse 11, rather. Ephesians 6 and 11. See, these things, sisters and brothers, are put here so we will understand. How is it you're going to have faith in somebody and don't do anything that they say? Surely somebody has been woefully misled. Ephesians 6, and let's start at verse 11. Okay, go ahead.
Put on the whole armor of God, that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil.
Go ahead.
For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places.
Look, sisters and brothers, and put on the whole armor of God, that you might be withstand the wiles of the devil.